one and all two super kids. Now on this show, Superman, who is he? Spider-Man, go home. Right here we have the true heroes of the future, our super kids. People to make the world a better place. We will search for one super kid today. Where from? From Leda Elementary School. That's right, as ever, we will start off with 20 contestants. We're going to go down to one. Will we find a hero today? You'll have to watch and see. Let's begin with the first round. Let's go! Let the battle begin. Ding, ding. This is round one, and it's called Guess What? We have two teams of five contestants ready to see who will go to round two. We have the apple team and the lemon team. I think they're smiling. Are you ready?
Yes!
Just about ready, I think. Now, it will be the best of three. First of all, you must find out what the word is. Bzz, spell me. Buzz me and tell me the answer. Okay then, first of all, who will go first? Here is your starter question to see who will go first. Right, get ready on your buzzers. Here we go. What did the Little Mermaid sacrifice to the witch in order to become a human? That is the apple team. Do you have an answer?
Answer is pretty voice.
Is that the answer? It is. Excellent. We can get started. Apple team, can you choose the first balloon, please, from 1 to 7? Go ahead.
Number 3.
Oh, no. What a bad start. You have found one of the bombs that we hide in there to be very cruel and nasty to you. So I'm sorry, Apple team, you don't get a chance. Okay, we'll move to the Lemon team. Can you choose a balloon, please?
Number 7.
Lucky number 7. It's an N, and here is your clue.
I am small in size.
Something small with an N in it. Take a guess if you like. Get it quickly. Time's nearly up. They're gonna give it a guess. What's your answer?
Snail.
Snail? Small. Snail, a small snail. You got the answer. That's amazing. Are you happy?
Yes.
You look very happy. Okay, that is the Lemon team 1 and the Apple team 0. So, let's begin. Lemon team, this is word number 2. You can choose the first balloon.
Number 2.
Number 2. Okay, it's a pea, and here is your clue.
I grow on trees.
You can have a guess? What's your guess?
Apple.
No. We wouldn't give you apple. That's way too easy. Okay, over to the apple team. Okay, it's your turn to choose a balloon. Go ahead.
Number 5.
Number 5. That is an H. It's not a bum. Here is your clue.
Pink flowers grow on my tree.
Answer is peach.
Goodness me. I can tell we're gonna have a tough time today. There are lots of super kids out there, potential super kids. It's 1-1. Lemon team 1, apple team 1. Apple team, it's your turn. This is the third word. Choose the first balloon.
Number 3.
Number 3. Diddly diddly dee. Oh. Apple team, do you like bombs? You're finding them all today. Oh dear, you miss out on a chance to get the answer. Over to the lemon team. Choose a balloon, please.
Number four.
It's AC, and here's the clue.
The more you use me, the shorter I get.
Lots of discussion going on. Oh, the buzzer is hit. What is your answer?
The answer is chalk.
You got it right. Well, so at this point now, the lemon team have two, and the apple team has one. You are both excellent, excellent teams, but today, the lemon team, you will go to the next round. And guess what? We use so many skills, your spelling and your logic. So always keep your eyes on that puzzle. All the answers are right there. And right now we got two more teams. We got the Kiwi team and the Orange team going head to head to see who will go through to round number two. First, here's your starter question to see who will choose the first balloon. Get ready. Here it comes. What animal does the head of the Sphinx look like?
The answer is lion.
Yep, you got it. Okay, Kiwi team, you get the first chance to choose the first balloon, which will reveal a letter. So go ahead, what number?
Number four.
That is a P. And can we have the first clue, please?
I have a pleasant smell.
A pleasant smell. Begins with P. No. Do you want to guess? Time ringing out. Gonna have to rush you. And we'll say stop there and go over to the orange team. Choose a balloon.
Number two.
It is an A. You've got a P and an A. And here's another clue.
I come in various shapes and colors.
Answer is pizza.
No, it's not pizza. Good guess. There is a P and there is an A in pizza. That's not right, though. Sorry. Over to the Kiwi team.
Number six.
It's an S. A P, an A, an S, and another clue.
Long ago, I was made by mixing ashes and oil.
The answer is soap.
That's right, yes, the Kiwi team have got that one now. So the Kiwi team have got the first one. That's the first one. It's 1-0 to the Kiwi team. They got soap, and they get to choose the next balloon. Oh, it's a longer word this time. Go ahead.
Number four.
It's an A, and here's the first clue.
I can live for a long time.
The answer is whale.
Sorry, good guess. Orange team, come on, you've got to get back now. You're playing catch up. So can you choose a balloon, please?
Number one.
Oh, an O and an A. Give us a clue.
I am a fast growing plant.
A fast growing plant lives a long time. An O and an A. The answers are right there on the... Okay.
Answer is bamboo.
Yes, you got it. That's right. So, lives a long time, a fast-growing plant. And now it's usually green and it's hollow on the inside. Who likes to eat bamboo? Do you know what animal?
Panda.
They are so clever. Pandas like to eat bamboo. It is a tie. 1-1. Who will go through? Let us see. Don't go away. Don't switch off the TV. Orange team, you get to choose the balloon. Go, go, go.
Number three.
Oh, boom, boom, shake the room. That's the bomb. He found it again. Okay, Kiwi team, go ahead. Choose a balloon.
Number eight.
V. Give us the first clue, please.
I have pink, purple, and white flowers.
The answer is clover.
Clover? It is clover. That is the national plant, the national flower, if you like, of Ireland. And if you get a four-leaf clover, it's very, very lucky. Well, I think the Kiwi team has a four-leaf clover in their pocket somewhere because they have got lucky and they've got 2 points. They're going on to the next round. So we have two teams through to the next round. Let's not pause, let's not breathe. Let's move right along to round two. Seconds out, round two, and it's called Flip It Over. It is the true or false round here. Now, basically, we will go for it. And the first three contestants to get three incorrect answers will be out. And we'll go through seven. We'll go through to the next round. So get ready, true or false. Here we go, right into it. Question number one.
Air has weight.
True or false? Ooh, we've got some mixed answers here. Four people say false, the others say true, and the answer is true. Oh, here we go. You'll be switched to yellow. There we go. From white to yellow. Don't worry, it's still early stages. We've got two more chances. Don't get nervous. Let's get ready now. Number two is coming up. Get your X's and your O's ready, because here it is, number two.
Cactus's thorns are the evolution of leaves.
This time we just have one X, three X's, the rest O's. So the answer is true. It is true. Number 10, that is Yain. You must be very careful now. You are on red. And also Tina moves to yellow. There you go, Changmin. Now you've got your yellow. Okay, Yain, be very careful. You are on red, but good luck. Good luck. Try not to get it wrong this time. Here we go. Number three.
Snails have bones in their body.
Bones or no bones? No bones. It's an X. It is false. This time, we have one going on to red. We have one, two, three, four people with O's. Four people with O's. Okay, so we've got that sorted out. I can now see three people with reds. They must be very, very careful as we move to the next question. Nervous, nervous, nervous. Next question, please.
There are seven members on a baseball team.
Oh-ho, seven members on the baseball team. Is that true or false? It is false. So, let's see what happens now. The incorrect were 14, number 9, number 8, number 12. Changmin, I'm very sorry, but we have to say bye-bye. Bye, Changmin. Everybody, give her a clap. Round two, Flip It Over continues. It's getting exciting. Let's have the next question, please.
The Leaning Tower of Pisa is located in Spain.
Hmm. Now we just have one person who says that's true. That's true. But it is actually incorrect. That is false. That is false. That was number 7, Leon. Leon, do you know where the Leaning Tower of Pisa is? Which country? Where does pizza come from? Do you know? And that is the answer. It's Italy, Italy. You're now on red, Leon. Be careful. Dangerous, dangerous color. Okay then, it's time to move on to the next question.
For anything to burn, it has to be exposed to oxygen.
Ho, ho, ho. A mixture of X's and O's. I'll tell you what the answer is. It's true. You need oxygen for something to burn. Number 15. That is Kim Jin-ha. Kim Jin-ha. She's still smiling, but I'm sorry. It's time for you to go home. Bye-bye. Give her a clap. Red is the color of danger, and that's what it means for some of our contestants now. We need one more who will go and sit down before we move on to the next round. Who will it be? Next question.
A tenor refers to the highest range a female can sing.
True or false? Again, we have a mixed bag. True or false? It is false. It's false. Ho, ho, ho. So we have 3 X's there. They're all on red. So I think we have a tiebreaker. Could you stand up, please? Number 11, number 7, and number 10. Right, the answer was false. It is soprano, which is the correct answer. Now, all 3 of you technically are out. But as there are 3 of you, we will need this tiebreaker. Listen carefully to this question. True or false?
Gold sticks to magnets.
True or false? We have 2 trues, 1 false. The answer is false. False. So number 10. Number 10 is Yein. You can sit down. And now. Over that side, 2 people left. It is Hyoji and Eun-young who will battle it out. Next question, please.
Arthur Conan Doyle is the author of Sherlock Holmes.
Oh, 1 true, 1 false. Who's gonna go and sit down? The answer is true. True, Eun-young, she's still not looking happy. Hyoji, I'm sorry, it's time to say bye-bye. That's the end of Flip It Over, which is round 2. How many contestants do we have left? We have 7. We're moving on to round 3, which is called Zoom In.
Is located on Namsan. In the middle of Seoul is a cozy yellow building surrounded by blue cinema. We are famous for our yellow uniforms, school building, and school buses.
The founder of our school thought it was best to use the color yellow for it to keep children visible and safe. Another advantage of our yellow uniforms is that our students give off a cheerful appearance to the public.
Another symbol of our school is our marching band. Either every morning when we have assemblies or when a special event is held, these determined musicians strut their stuff. All Lila students learn and enjoy playing the flute.
We may not have a distinct sound, but we do have our own unique sense of charm when performing.
Finally, we introduce our ice fairies, who practice skating until late evening once a week. This is for a healthy and happy life.
Our athletes were exceptional in this year's Winter Olympics. After having witnessed that, it prompted us to work even harder.
Lila kids work hard to become a gold medalist in the fields of their choice. In order to be globally recognized, Lila students will continue to hone their skills day by day. Hooray, Lila!
And we're back with our search for a super kid today. And this is called Zoom In. It's the really intellectual corner. Well, we ask all our contestants to read a certain book, and all the questions we will give them are about that book. We need to find four contestants. If they get two questions right, they go on to the Magic Cubes. And the book today is Peter Pan. So listen to this.
Peter Pan, written by English novelist James Barry, is a children's bestseller about the adventures of Peter Pan and his friends, the Lost Boys. Since it was first published in 1904, the innumerous movies and plays have captured the imagination of all children. This story was a must-read for our contestants today. Let's have a better look at Peter Pan's wild adventures.
Okay, so all our contestants have read the story. Are you ready with your buzzers? Are you ready? No, I don't think so. Are you ready?
Yes!
Now they're ready. Can we have question number one, please?
James Barry's Peter Pan is an adventurous story about Peter and Wendy traveling to an imaginative land. When Peter first visited Wendy's house, he lost this.
Aha, that is Chinu, number 40. What's your answer?
The answer is Shadow.
Good job. Excellent, there's your hairband there, Chinu. Oh, wow, you look fantastic. Wonderful, wonderful. Chinu,
yes.
Did you enjoy reading Peter Pan?
Yes.
Oh, you did. What was your favorite part of the story?
Everything.
You enjoyed the whole story. Yeah. I'm a big fan myself. Well, if you enjoyed it, maybe it will help you move on to the Magic Cubes. We shall see. Okay, this time the question is multiple choice. Okay, so maybe you want to wait right until the end to hear your options. Okay, can we have question number two, please?
How old are you, Peter?
I don't know. I ran away from home the day I was born.
Really? Why did you do that?
I heard my mother and father talking, but I don't want to. Why did Peter run away from his home?
One, he wanted to live with missing children. Two, he was afraid of his parents. Three, he didn't want to grow up.
Aha, that's number seven. That's Uyong. Uyong, do you have an answer, please? Yeah.
The answer is number three.
Number three? You got it. That's right. I mentioned before, Peter Pan didn't want to grow up. He wanted to be a boy forever and ever. Maybe that's something I would like too, but not anymore. Okay, Uyong, well done. Congratulations. You got one right. You're one step away from going to the Magic Cubes. Listen up. There's a long way to go yet. Now, this is a short answer question. No options. So, here we go.
Until now, Peter Pan has been loved for 100 years since it was published. Just like Peter, I'm sure there are people who have dreamed of never growing up. What is this place where Peter lives?
All right, this time it's number 13. That is Kyutong. What's the answer?
The answer is Neverland.
Neverland? You're right. Excellent. Well done there. He already looked cute, and now he's even cuter. Wow, he's got one of the best smiles I have ever seen. I'd pay good money for that smile. Okay, good job. We got three people now, three contestants with 1 point each. The search continues. Here is the next question.
The story of Hook came from Peter Pan. In the movie, there is a weird crocodile that always follows Captain Hook around. Hook hears a strange sound coming.
The answer is clock.
You got it. A clock sound, the sound of a clock. Tick tock inside the crocodile. That's how he got Hook. Chinu, guess what? You're in the next round. You're into the magic cubes. Go and stand up behind those monitors, please. Okay. Whew. So we have one into the magic cubes round. Next, who'll be going? Let's find out. Now, this is another multiple choice question. So you will have options after the question. Here we go.
Hey, take me to the boat.
Captain, are you sure?
Our plans are ruined. The lost child found his mother.
What a day.
Captain, what about kidnapping the boy's mother?
That's a great idea.
Why did the pirates want to kidnap Wendy? Mm-hmm. One, to lure Peter.
Oh, Hyung-suk's coming very early here. Hyung-suk.
The answer is number one.
Sorry, Hyung-suk. You still have to do your homework. Okay, let's listen to the rest of the options.
Two. Hook was head over heels for Wendy. Three, to have Wendy as their mother.
Number seven, that's Uyong.
The answer is number three.
Good job. Yes, everybody in the story seems to want Wendy as their mother. So did the pirates. Uyong, you got the correct answer. Where are you going? You're going on to the magic cubes. Go and take your place right there next to Chinu. We're moving quickly. We're moving in a very quick manner. We've got two in the magic cubes. We need to find another two contestants. Get ready. Here we go. Here is the next question. Listen carefully.
What did you do to her?
I don't want to move her. She could get hurt. I know what to do. Shall we make something for her?
Great idea.
What did the boys and Peter make for Wendy who had...
Okay, Kyudong. What's the answer?
The answer is a small house.
Yes! Excellent! Kyudong, a small house for Wendy. And that's why a long time ago, children's houses used to be called Wendy houses. There you go. Okay, Kyudong, you still smiling? There he is, a smiling, giggling and laughing all the way into the magic cubes. Okay, here is the next question. Listen carefully, only one place left in the final round. Here we go.
Suddenly, Hook jumped up.
This is hot.
Captain Hook and the pirates were watching very carefully. They picked up on smoke coming from this. By seeing this, they found out where Peter Pan was. What is this?
Oh, that is number nine. That's Chuno.
The answer is mushroom.
Yes, it is. Excellent. That was a very difficult question. There is your magical hairband. There you go. Congratulations. You got the question right. You need just one more to go into the magic cubes. Okay. Can we have the next question, please? Listen carefully.
When Hook went back to the forest to catch Peter Pan, he used this to get the children out of the underground house. This instrument is used when Indians win a battle. What is this instrument called?
Oh, okay. That is Chuno.
The answer is drum.
You're correct. Absolutely, the answer is drum. The Indians, tom-tom, bum-ba-da-bum-bum-bum. Chuno, if you have a drum right here, right now, you can play it, because you can celebrate. You're into the magic cubes. We have four contestants now, waiting nervously. It's time to get serious. It's big business. It's the magic cube.
Introducing four kids advancing to the magic cubes. Contestant number 7 is an ice fairy, Kim Eui-young. Contestant number 13, Kang Kyu-dong, he's a bookworm. Contestant number 9, Son Jun-ho wants to be a doctor. Contestant number 14, a future wealthy businessman, Oh Jin-woo.
20, 10, 7, and now there are four. We are into the round we call the magic cubes. Anything can happen from now on. Here with us now are our contestants, Eui-young, Kyu-dong, and Chun-ho, and Jin-woo. How do you feel? Even Kyu-dong is not smiling. Oh, there we go. We have a smile. Are you nervous?
No.
Are you sure all four of you are not nervous? Eui-young is nervous. You should be nervous. It's a tough round. Okay, then. We have four. We need one. It's time for the magic cubes. Here we go. There are the categories. I will choose costume. That's the first category. That is costume. Listen up to our question.
People have worn this for thousands of years for various purposes. In earlier times, these were used for hunting, to make the hunter look like an animal and let him get closer to his prey. In ancient Greece and Rome, actors used to wear these in the theater to clearly show the character of the role they were playing.
Okay, that is Eui-young buzzing in first. What is your answer?
The answer is mask.
You're absolutely right. The answer is mask. You get the first point, and your character there, your beautiful character, has put on some more clothes, which is good. We don't want your character getting cold. Okay, Eui-young, you got the first point. It's your turn to choose a category. Go ahead.
I'll choose 11.
Okay, this is going to be a question from one of the alumni from your school. So, watch them and listen carefully. There's the magic stick there as well. You could win a magic stick and a point. Here we go.
Hello, everyone. I am Jihee Kim, 24th graduating class of Lida Elementary School. I currently work at the Boeing Company, the world's leading aerospace company and the largest manufacturer of commercial jetliners and military aircraft. How are you doing with answering questions so far? I'm sure smart Lida students are doing very well. Now, please listen carefully. Here's your question. This was invented by an Australian named David Warren. With any airplane crash, there are many unanswered questions as to what brought the plane down. Investigators turned to this to get details of the events immediately preceding the accident. Another name for this is flight data recorder and cockpit voice recorder. From its common name, you cannot tell its color is actually very bright, like red or orange. What is this?
That is Jin-woo.
The answer is light.
Sorry, Chinu. It's a tough question, this one. It is tough. We're going to give you 5 seconds. A black box. The black box. When the plane crashes, this records all the data. It was a tough one. Okay, nobody actually answered that correctly. The magic stick is gone. And I will choose the next category. Part and whole. That's my favorite category. Part and whole. Now, in this section, you must look at some pictures. The pictures are of one object. Okay? It's a series of small pictures. Guess what that object is. Here we go. Part and whole. There you go. That's your first picture. What is it? Can you tell it? That is Uyong again.
The answer is elevator.
Yes, it is. Well done, Uyong. There it is. You can see it right there. It is an elevator. I do like that category. Uyong, quick question for you. You obviously study a lot because you're very clever. But when you're not studying, what do you like to do?
I like to watch TV.
You like watching TV? Okay, what kind of TV programs do you like?
I like to watch music programs.
Music programs. Do you have a favorite singer or music band?
Yes.
Could you tell me?
SS501.
I'm old. I feel really old. I don't know who this is. Okay, excellent. I'm sure they're a wonderful group. Okay, well done, well done. You've got 2 points. Boys, are you okay? Just do this. Clean your ears a little bit. There we go. Okay, here we go. Uyong, choose the next category, please.
Number 12.
Okay, here we go.
Mendelssohn's Wedding March was used in the 5th chapter of A Midsummer Night's Dream. This piece was based on a play by England's greatest writer, Shakespeare. The English once said that he could never be exchanged for India. England's greatest novelist, Shakespeare, is famous for his 4 tragedies, Hamlet, Othello, Macbeth, and this.
Oh, Kyudong. Okay. What is your answer?
King Lear.
Oh. You got it! And his smile grows bigger. Did you guess, Kyudong?
Yes.
You guessed, but you got that one right. That was excellent. You now have a point, and you now have the opportunity to choose a category.
Number 4, Alps.
Number 4, the Alps.
While listening to Peter Hinn's Berner Oberlin, this is a form of singing, making a high-low sound. Sung in mountainous areas, what is this pleasant song called?
That is Uyong. What is the answer?
The answer is yodel.
Yodelay, yodelay, yodelay. Was that bad? Okay, yes, the answer was yodeling. It's a very beautiful sound, I think. Well, never mind the sound. You've got another point, Uyong. Right now, you've got 3 points. And the boys are just behind there. 1.00. Come on, boys. You can do it. There's a long way to go. Lots of questions left. You can still be the one that goes through to the super round. Okay, Uyong, it's up to you again. Which category this time?
I'll choose number 2, shape.
Number 2, shape.
Do you like basketball? Both basketball and volleyball courts are rectangular shaped. A wrestling ring is round. One of the 4, which one is out of a different shape? 1, floor exercise. 2, boxing. 3, shidam.
Okay, that is Chuno this time.
The answer is number 3.
Number 3, yes! Shidam. Shidam, for anybody who doesn't know, that is traditional Korean wrestling. So do you know what is the shape of the area where they...
Round.
Excellent. And it's your turn to choose a category. Go ahead.
Number 10.
Okay, number 10 is 15th century. Ooh, and the magic box. I can hear your friends behind you go, magic box, magic box. That's right. You could win the magic box if you get the right answer. Here we go, the 15th century.
A Renaissance Baroque arts exhibition was recently held at the Seoul Art Center, offering Koreans a chance to meet the great works of the artists of that time. The artworks that are shown on the screen right now, The Virgin of the Rocks, Study of a Woman's Head, The Arno Valley, are all done by one man.
Oh, Chuno, looking to win the magic box. Have you got the right answer, though?
I don't know.
Go ahead.
Leonardo da Vinci.
You've cracked the Da Vinci code. Yes, you have. The answer was Leonardo da Vinci. You have now got 2 points, and you've got the magic box, which could help you if you go through to the super round. Chinu, are you okay?
Yes.
Don't worry, don't worry. I'm sure you can come back still. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Categories left. You could still go through. Okay, good luck. Okay, don't worry. So, Chuno, can you choose the next category, please?
Number one.
Number one, that is food. Do we have something delicious?
France's Louis XIV was said to have ate this every day. This in Latin means to soak in salt. It is said that Westerners who eat lots of meat used to sprinkle this or raw vegetables on the meat. What is this called?
Chinu, this could be your first point.
The answer is salad.
Yes, it is. There you go. What did I tell you? You've got your first point now. Excellent. Everybody's got a point. Everybody's still in the game. The answer was salad. That's right, usually raw vegetables or salad vegetables. People put on dressing, mayonnaise. I like a good salad, especially in the summer. Okay, Chinu, it's your turn to choose the next category. Go ahead.
Number 8, games.
Number 8, games.
In America, this game was first launched in carnivals and exhibitions. Later on, it was commercialized. This originally came from a children's game of numbers. The play card has 25 rectangles.
Gyudong. Give it a go.
The answer is bingo.
Bingo? Yes! B-I-N-G-O, B-I-N-G-O, that's right, bingo. Also the name of the dog in that song I was singing. excellent, Gyudong, well done. You've moved to 2 points. And I think, Chunho, you knew the answer, didn't you? You just couldn't remember. Okay, Gyudong, we've got 3 categories left. Please go ahead and choose one.
Number 7, plan.
Number 7, plan. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da! It is that section of the program where no longer are you individuals, you're a team. And you get the opportunity to give something back to society. That's right. We will play the game, here you go, a word train game. Depending on how many words you can do in that train, that will be how many books we will give to somebody who really needs those books. Now, the record is still 17. Can you break the record? With the help of your friends behind me here, they will give you, here you go. Are you ready?
Yes.
The character will give you the first word. Gyudong, you will be first. You chose the category, okay? Okay, character, can you give us the first word, please?
Hi, buddy. We love spelling. Let's go. Comes the first word. Plan N. Here you go.
Nurse E.
Here you go.
Ear R.
Here you go.
Rabbit. T.
Here you go.
Television. N.
Here you go.
Necklace. L.
Kudong. Necklace L. What's the last letter of necklace? Anybody?
S.
E. Don't worry, you did well. You got 4. That's not bad. That's not bad. It doesn't break the record of 17. We'll be sending those books off very soon. Good job. Good job. 2 categories left. Kudong. It's your turn to choose a category again. Which one?
Number 6, sign.
Sign. Okay. Now listen to the following conversation and choose what sign the two people are looking at. So you're going to be listening and looking. Here we go.
Wow, there are so many cars here. I don't think we can find a place to park.
Oh, there's an empty space. Let's park over there.
No, we can't. Don't you see the sign? It's for the handicapped.
Oops, I didn't see the sign.
Wow, that was... Chinu, number 14. Chinu, what is the answer? Which one?
Number 2.
Yep. So not so long ago, Chinu, you were stood there, you had 0 points, you were looking not depressed, but sad. You're coming back. How do you feel now? Better.
So, yeah.
Much better. Okay. It's 3, 2, 2, 2. It's very, very close. It's very tight. Are you ready? I'm ready. Here is the final category.
Monaco, with Monaco as the capital city, is famous for casinos and Grand Prix racing. There are several places in the world where the name of the country and its capital city are the same. What following countries do not have the same country and capital city name? 1. Luxembourg. 2. Kuwait. 3. Tunisia. 4. Singapore.
It is Chinu. He's making a late run for it. I think he might be going for a guess here. 1, 2, 3, or 4. What do you think?
Number 3.
Goodness me. Well, I'm looking at the scores and I'm quite shocked, to say the least. Right now, Uyan has 3. Kudong has 2. Chuno has 2. And Chinu has 3. We have a tie. Uyang and Chinu, you're tying with 3 points each. So what is this in my hand, I ask you? It is the tiebreaker question between Uyang and Chinu. Relax, relax. Who is going into the super round? Listen carefully. Originally, this means happiness and being healthy. However, in Korea, it has recently been understood as seeking a healthy lifestyle by staying physically and mentally healthy. Uyang, do you feel confident?
No.
No? You're either gonna give a chance to Chinu or you're going to the super round. What is your answer?
My answer is well-being. Well-being.
That was a battle. That was a battle royale. Uyang, you will be going to the super round today. Uyang is through to that super round. She'll have to get 3 out of 5 questions to be the winner today. Will she do it? We will have to wait and see. We'll be right back. The program, Super Kids. The round, Super Round. Just one contestant left. Can she be a Super Kid? Kim Uy Young. You're looking a little nervous. When you feel nervous, Uyong, usually who do you think about? Who makes you feel better?
My mom.
Your mom. You know what? Me too. Me too. When I'm nervous, I think about my mom. Now, your friends here behind me, they've prepared something to make you feel better, to push you towards triumph. So, if you're ready, kids, go for it.
Uyong, Uyong, you can do it.
The rules are easy. The questions are difficult. I have five questions here. Uyong, if you get three correct of the five, you will be today's Super Kid. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. Question number one. Also known as the Sun King, this man was highly represented during the heyday of the French Bourbon Kings. A remarkable monarch. This man on his deathbed quoted, "I am going, but the state shall remain." Which king built the Palace of Versailles? The king who built the Palace of Versailles, also known as the Sun King. Take your time. I'll just give you 5 seconds thinking time. Here we go. Well, do you have an answer?
No.
Okay. The answer was King Louis XIV. Don't worry. That was only question number one. Four more questions. Okay. Relax. Listen carefully. Question number two. Listen to the following words I give you and tell me what comes to mind. Looking for a one-word answer. Ocarina. Foie gras. Charles Perrault. Golden egg. Nemesis. Looking for one word that has a link with all those words. Uyong, I'm gonna have to ask you, do you have an answer?
No.
Okay, I'll give you 5 more seconds thinking time. Do you have an answer? Goose. The goose that laid the golden egg. That was the answer. You've got 2 wrong. There's no room for error now. You got to get 3 correct in a row. Are you ready? Okay, here we go. Question number 3. The Statue of Justice comes to mind when we think of representations or symbols of the law. In one hand, this Statue of Justice holds a sword. In the other hand, she holds this. The sword stands for punishment towards people disrupting social order. In the other hand, it represents fair justice. What is this? Have an answer yet?
No.
Here's 5 seconds. 5 seconds. So sword in one hand. Any in the other hand? Do you know?
The answer is a book. Book?
I'm sorry, Ooyong. The answer is scales. A scale. A sword and a scale. That means, I'm afraid, you've not managed to get one of the questions right in the super round. We don't have a super kid for today. But Kim Ooyong from Lida Elementary School, you've done very well. We started with 20 students. We came down to one. You're not a super kid, but you still are super. Everybody give her a round of applause.
Arirang is looking for natural-born super kids. Elementary schools that have what it takes can visit Arirang's homepage, www.arirang.co.kr, and click on the Super Kids link. We're waiting for you to seize the challenge.
And so we come to the end of another episode of Super Kids. Unfortunately, Ooyong did very, very well. She tried her hardest, but not this time, afraid. She's not a super kid today, but she was super. So that's it for another episode. We'll be back searching the world for super kids next time. Bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye.